Good morning. I have to make this quick. My camera's gonna die. Welcome to today's fitness and health vlog. I don't remember what number we're on. I think it's number 4. How are we lighting? I think that I'm just gonna show you guys what I've been eating because currently your girl was at 174.9. So I was gonna make this vlog and do after Thanksgiving, how to get back in shape after Thanksgiving. And Thanksgiving had zero, like surprisingly, shockingly, zero effect on my weight. So that was really good because I ate like a motherfucker. So I was really happy when I went on the scale like a couple days ago and I was like, everything's fine. I did eat a lot, but I also was kind of smart about it. Like, I think that after the juice cleanse, my mind on food has totally changed. How I eat, the times I eat, I know when I'm actually full now, where I'm like, or is it just delicious? Or are you just eating to eat? So even though Thanksgiving my plates were stacked high, I probably hadn't had anything to eat, like aside from maybe breakfast that day. Like not to say skip meals, I'm just saying I ended up sleeping in a lot. We went home, so I slept in. I would eat like, say, probably closer to noon, and then just wait for dinner at like 4 or 5. So I don't think it had that bad of an effect on me because I didn't go back for seconds. So I ate what I ate and I left it there. It was very rare that I went back and like added a whole bunch more. It's probably like a taste of a thing or two, but it wasn't bad. It was one or two desserts, so it wasn't bad. So 174.9 is where we stand today. So I want to show you guys what I'm eating and how I'm exercising. I'm still doing Apple Fitness because I love that. But now my structure is either like 30 minutes of yoga or Pilates and then 30 minutes of HIIT. So I find that doing that, because yoga and Pilates really engage your core, and that's where I find I need the strength, core, arms. So it's really good exercises until I can get my weights, because I actually ended up getting a dog. So I didn't want to spend $500 on weights. We'll spend $1,000 plus on a dog, obviously. So anyways, now that I am not buying the weights anytime soon, I have to get back into my fitness routine. I also didn't work out for the 2 weeks. I was off for 2 weeks. And now I'm just trying to get my life together, get into a routine with the puppy, get into a routine back on my fitness and my YouTube journey. So it's kind of like a lot of things are happening at once. So I figured today would be a good day just to show you guys what I eat today and show you one of my like hour workouts. And I try to work out maybe 3 times a week right now, even though again, this is my first week back. Today's Thursday, so I actually have to work out today so I can work out hopefully tomorrow or Saturday and get my 3 days in. I think 3 days is just more realistic for someone who's like on a journey like this. When you have a whole bunch of stuff to do, 3 days, I'm exhausted. Having a puppy and getting up at 5 o'clock, exhausted. So right now it's about 8 o'clock, so I'm gonna have my first meal. I should have had my coffee already, but I didn't. I'm putting milk in my coffee and I'm having caffeinated coffee lately because I'm exhausted. Tired. She's a mom now, a mother, no drama. So I'm gonna make that and I'm gonna show you what it looks like. Look at me. Remy's here, y'all. He heard the bag and thought it was treats. It's not. This is my coffee. Sorry, I'm out of focus. So I use the Nescafe Instant Silk Almond for coffee. And then to eat, I'm having Silk Almond Yogurt. And I add a lot of granola. It's mostly just granola, honestly. And the yogurt. And I eat this and then I don't eat again until about 10 o'clock. Especially with working in an office, having the juice cleanse really put me on like a routine of like 8 o'clock, 10:30, 1 o'clock, 3:30. So I tend to eat like really, really well right now, timing wise. Okay, so for my 10 o'clock snack, I'm actually pretty late today, but my 10 o'clock snack is usually like a trail mix of sorts. So I take unsalted peanuts or an unsalted nut with a salted nut. Because these are the Costco size dry roasted almonds, they come salted. I like to have like one nut salted just because it makes things taste better, but definitely not all of them. This I also got at Costco. They're basically mini fruit bars. They're like fruit to go, but this is what one looks like. Like super good, like literally all that's in there is fruit. So cut that up, and some cheese is in there as well. And then a serving like this much should fill me for the next hour and a half, and then we'll get into lunch, which is usually just a late snack. Sorry, ignore my dog. He's like freaking out because he wants to come out of the pen, but he's gotta stay in there for now.
So this is what I have for my basically like lunch type situation. Probably a tea or some water. I've drank like a bottle of water already today, or at least half, like 500 milliliters. So I'm pretty hydrated. So I'm like, I'm just gonna have another tea to fill me up until my next snack. Rice cakes. Why did I say that so enthusiastically? Rice cakes, carrots, and hummus.
Don't sleep on rice cakes, because as much as plain rice cakes are like the body of Christ, plain, bland, I get all of that. They are the best way to eat a carb and get full without eating bread, rice, all those things that like pack on the pounds. So my like rice cakes save me. Like anything I can do on bread, I try to do on rice cakes. It's obviously not as practical with a sandwich, but maybe make like a deconstructed sandwich. So like turkey, lettuce, rice cakes on the side. You know what I mean? So you have to get creative with it, but it's definitely filling. So it's just a handful of carrots, some hummus, and some rice cakes and a tea or a beverage. And then I'm gonna continue to drink my water. And then we have our last snack. And then we have dinner. And then I usually have a tea around 8 o'clock. So you'll see how that plays out. But right now we're at our 1 o'clock. Lunch. So let's get into it.
So for my 3:30 snack, I usually have orange slices and grapes, or just like a whole orange cut into slices. I was actually at work this day because the day that I'm vlogging, I did not have this snack. I ended up just getting caught up in doing something and totally forgot to eat. So yeah, this is what I would eat around 3 o'clock and then not eat again until dinner at around 6 o'clock. Okay, so this is my dinner. I ended up skipping my 3:30 snack, but I'll have it later. And it's just some garlic bread, salmon, and a Greek salad that Tyler made. And it all looks delicious, so I'm gonna dive into that now.
All right, so I'm filming. I need a bit of a pick-me-up. So as you can see, I'm having chocolate, I'm having ice cream. I think a common misconception is like, if you're dieting, you can't have a sweet thing. Like when they say everything in moderation, they're not lying. I still eat sweet things. I just don't. I used to like have something sweet like almost after every meal. That's crazy. Like you ever think about that stuff and like, oh my gosh, I had a donut with my coffee today. I went for lunch and then had a Starbucks frappuccino with a banana bread. And then when I came home from dinner and I had a chocolate bar. And it's like, yeah, you can definitely cut out at least two of those sweets. So that's my one thing, This week's a bad week. I'm pretty sure my period's starting soon. So I find that, especially when I'm heading into that week, I can't say no to the one thing. It's happening. I'm not even gonna try and fight it. It's happening. So I encourage you to lean into it a little bit. It'll keep you going, keep you motivated to be able to enjoy your sweet treats and not feel guilty because you, like, I ate so clean today that I'm like, whatever, I don't care. And also keep in mind, if you're trying to lose a lot of weight in a short period of time, you cannot do this. I was gracious enough to give myself 15 pounds over the course of 8 months of the year. I still have 2 months to go, 5 more pounds. I'm gonna have this fucking problem. Like, I'm just saying, like if I'm doing the math right, I can have strict weeks and may be able to burn that. So it's like, you have to keep that in mind. If you're trying to lose a lot of weight really quickly, yes, you probably have to be way stricter. I'm not trying to, I'm just trying to at least hit my short-term goal of 170 by the end of this year, and then I'll leave 160 for next year. And I think that that's totally reasonable. But anyway, I have to film. And then after that, some workouts.
Mm-hmm. It's not a toy. So thank you guys so much for watching that video. I just finished working out, as you can see, and I'm sweating and I'm tired, so I'm gonna shower, go to bed, and I will check in with you guys next month, and we'll see the results of this type of plan that I have in place as of today, and we'll see
what the results are after that. So I'm gonna try and do this probably 3 or 4 times for the week, eat like this, exercise like this 3 or 4 times for a week for the next month, and then at the end of November, beginning of December, I'll check in and let you guys know where I stand. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you did like it, please give it a big thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any questions, comments, or concerns about anything I did today. Leave that in the comments down below. And as always, subscribe to me. You pay my bills, right? Again, thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye.